So we continue with the language of chemistry, and we were talking about the valency. So I said that the valency, if it is positive in nature, we are talking about metals. So metals will always have a plus valency, like Na 1 plus, Mg 2 plus, Al 3 plus, okay. If it is only having one valency, then it will be monovalent. If it has got two valency, it will be called as divalent. If it is three valency, it is trivalent. So that is the kind of valency. So yeah, the valency of the element, the non-metals, will be negative. So if it requires one electron to complete its outermost orbit, or it can combine with one hydrogen atom to fulfill its configuration or to become stable, then it is minus one, or you can say that negative valency for non-metals. But in chemistry, there are certain kind of substances which will be such that they exhibit not one valency but multiple valencies. They exhibit what is called as variable valency. This is because they do not actually obey the laws of the electronic configuration. Okay, if any particular elements, the elements in between, which are also called as the transition elements, they are the one which do not have a electronic configuration which is as per the rules, right? The 2, 8, वैसे वो होना चाहिए, वो नहीं है, rules के हिसाब से नहीं है. That's why what happens is their last orbit is incomplete. But not only that, even their second last orbit is incomplete. It's called as a penultimate orbit is also incomplete. So when a element is such that it has got not only its last orbit is incomplete, but also one of the second last one is incomplete, then that particular substance can achieve the electronic configuration, or it can achieve the status of nirvana bol sakte ho usko, yeah, you can call it as a nirvana, ke wo stable ho jaye, electronically stable ho jaye. To electronic stable hone ke liye uske paas do option hai, ya to wo apne penultimate wala bhi complete kare aur bahar ka bhi complete kare, ya to it just completes the outermost one and forgets about the penultimate one. So that's why it will be having double valency. It's called as variable valency. So the term certain elements exhibit more than one valency, showing variable valency. Reason for variable valency: valency is the number of electron lost or gained from the outermost shell of an atom of an element. During a chemical reaction, variations in this loss or gain result to variable valency. Okay, so they are not explained in detail, but the main thing is that when there is such that it is having a unstable electronic configuration, not only in the outermost orbit but also in its second last orbit, and then it is going to be a variable valency. For example, copper exhibits valency 1 and 2. Compounds of copper are named as follows. So old naming system, cuprous, that is CuCl, cuprous chloride. And valency 2 will be cupric or cupric chloride, that is CuCl2. And as per the new system, that is the IUPAC system of naming, it is copper 1 chloride, that is CuCl, and copper 2 chloride, that is CuCl2. So you can see over here, in very small letters, they have mentioned over here that why exactly is there valency 1 and 2 over here. So it is this way: copper has got the electron, the atomic number is 29, and due to that, so because it is 29, the electronic configuration will be 2, 8, and then you can have 18 over there, right? So it will be 18 and then 1, so that makes it 10, 29. Okay, so the outermost shell has one electron, and the penultimate last but one has 18 electrons. Now the penultimate shell has not attained stability, and one or more electrons sometimes jumps to the outermost shell, and the valence electrons thus increases, and copper has new electronic configuration as 2, 8, 17, 2. So when it is this way, this one will be its valency plus 1. So this will be Cu 1 plus. But when one of the electron from here jumps over here and comes here, because this is not stable, that's why the valency will become plus 2 to give you Cu2 plus. Got it? So, in this case, what happened? The penultimate shell is not getting completed. In this case, the penultimate shell is completed. So, when it is this way, it will be plus 1 valency. When it is this way, it will be plus 2 valencies. Don't worry if you have not understood this much clearly, because this is not so much important for you. Because itna detail mein jaane ka zarurat nahi, even in 10 sthan you are going to in the detail that why there is variable valency. But you should know that what is the variable valency. Now in case of variable valency, it is seen that there are two names given to this thing. One is the old method and the other one is a new method. The new method is also called as IUPAC, IUPAC, okay, that is International Union of Practicing Allied Chemistry. If I'm not wrong, it is this way, the International Union of Practicing Allied Chemistry. So, that is IUPAC name. Now, IUPAC over here is very easy. Okay, uske liye kya hai? You are not going to remember the valency at all, because the name itself has the valency in it. So if I'm writing this one, so if I'm talking about this copper, I'm going to write it as Cu1. If I'm talking about this one, so this one is Cu1+. If I'm talking about this one, it is Cu2. That means it is Cu2+. But that doesn't mean that we should not be aware about this old one, because many of the compound names in your chemistry textbook itself will be based on this system and not this system. So in this system, what used to happen is that you were giving the names. So over here, you were given some suffix. Okay. The two suffix were IC and OUS. So for example, if I'm talking about copper, which is originally coming from cuprum. Cuprum is the Latin name for copper, jiske par se Cu generate hua hai. So cuprum is said to be as cuprus. Okay? Ye UM nikal gaya aur ye add ho gaya, for which Q plus is nothing but Cu1+. So if the valency is smaller, if it is a smaller valency, it is us, Q plus. If it is a higher valency, it will be, this UM becomes IC, so it will be cupric, that is Cu2+. So any name which is ending with OUS means it has got its lower valency. And anything ending with IC will be its higher valency. For example, ferrous. Ferrous is Fe2+. Iron has got two valency, 2 and 3. So if I'm talking about the lower one, it will be ferrous. If I'm talking about the higher one, that is Fe3, it is ferric. Okay? Cuprum. Ka cuprous and cupric. Ferrum ka ferrous and ferric. Okay, there are so many of them. Argentum, argentic. Okay, argentus and argentic. Okay, manganous and manganic. Yeah, most of them has got variable valencies. So all the variable valencies are very, very important to know. And once you see this, the next page of yours is something which you will need to by heart completely. Because this is the way, this is the most important page, because if you know this page properly, then the formation of a compound is very, very easy. But to form a compound, to form the name of a compound, you need to learn these valency chart very, very, very thoroughly well. Okay. Bahut achhi tarah se isko by heart karna. So what is this particular table about? So you can see the table is about positive valencies and negative valencies, and they are given the different kinds of substances of monovalent, divalent and trivalent. So you can see the first part over here is the positive valency in the valency one part, that is the monovalent part. The positive valencies of the metals are, there will be potassium, which is K1+, sodium Na1+, hydrogen H1+, ammonium NH4+. Now here it should be known over here that the hydrogen, potassium, sodium, they all are elements. We very well know they are elements, but ammonium is not an element. Then how can it be coming over here? So such a kind of a group of atoms, when they combine together, but even after combining, if they are not able to satisfy their valency, then such a kind of a group of atoms are called as radicals. So let's see what are radicals. So it is this way that nitrogen combined with 4 hydrogen, and when it combined with 4 hydrogen, it was still not able to become a stable compound, and it had got one electron extra. That's why this becomes Na1+. So this over here is nothing but ammonium. It is not ammonia. Ammonia is NH3. This is ammonium, which is a ion, which is also called as a radical. So what is an ion or a radical? Atom or a group of atom. Okay, atom or a group of atom, when they have got not the same number of protons and electrons, that means they are not electrically stable. They have got either more number of atoms or more number of protons or more number of electrons. So if a particular compound element has already lost its electron, that it becomes positively charged. I'll just give you an example. Suppose we talk about sodium. The sodium is Na, which is, we know that it is 11. So the number of protons are equal to 11. And number of electrons are also equal to 11. Now, so this is 2, 8, 1. Now, if this one electron is lost, it is given away to some other element, then what will happen? The number of electrons will become 10. Now, because this will become 10, but this is still 11. So what will happen? The Na over here has become positively charged by 1. Okay? The Na has become one positive charge. That's the reason we call such a kind of an atom which has lost its electron as a positively charged ion. So this positive ion, also called as cation. Okay, it's also called as cation. So positively charged ion or cation is going to be formed when the element loses its electron. Similarly, if it is like this, if it is chlorine, so chlorine, we know it is 17, it's 2, 8, 7. So if it is going to gain, so it has got protons equal to 11, 17 and electrons equal to 17. If it gains one electron, it becomes 18. So now the protons are 17 and electrons are 18. So now the electrons are more, so negative charge is more, so the chlorine becomes 1-. Because it has got one electron more than the number of protons, that's why it is negatively charged, and such a one over here will be called as a negative ion, also called as anion. Okay, this is cation, this is anion. Okay, cation, anion. So accordingly, you will find that they have given the list of the positive valencies and the negative valencies. They are given, grouped it in the form of 1 valency, 2 valency, 3 valency. So you can see over here, valency 1, in case of the atom or radical, which is potassium, is K, K1 plus. Sodium is Na, Na1 plus. Hydrogen is H, H1 plus. Or ammonium is NH4, NH4 1 plus. So this is about the positive valency, which are monoatomic. Monovalent. Similarly, for negative valency, with 1 as the valency, that is monovalent negative valencies, we have got chlorine, that is Cl, that is Cl1 minus, which is also called as chloride. So in the form of a ion, chlorine will be called as chloride, IDE. Okay, with the suffix of IDE means chloride. If it is bromine, it is Br, Br1 minus, it is called as bromide. Iodine will be I1 minus, it will be iodide. Then it is nitrate. Nitrate are NO3 having, so nitrogen and 3 oxygen, when they combine together, they still do not become stable. Okay, nitrogen and oxygen, 3 oxygen atoms and 1 nitrogen atom, when they combine to form a compound, they could not form a compound because they still need one more, they still need one electron to complete their stability, to become stable, they need one electron. And because they need one more electron, that's why the nitrate, there is a group of the atoms together in the form of an ion, which we call it as a radical. So the radical NO3 is called as nitrate. So nitrate is NO3 and it has got a valency as 1 minus. Similarly, hydroxide is the formation of O and H. When O and H combine together to form a compound, it cannot form a compound, it just forms into a radical, because they still require one more electrons to complete its to become stable. That's why it is OH1 minus. Bicarbonate is HCO3, which will be HCO3 1 minus. Bisulfate is HSO3, which is going to be HSO3 1 minus. Bisulfate will be HSO4. Will be HSO4 1 minus. Aluminate will be AlO2 1 minus. And manganate, permanganate, will be MnO4 1 minus. So these are the valency 1 wala jitne bhi because there are plenty of them. We are just going to learn in the 8th standard a few of these. So these are the one which are going to learn by heart. So what do you need to learn over here? The moment somebody tells you what is a nitrate, you should be able to tell that nitrate is NO3 and its valency is 1 minus. If somebody tells you what is ammonia, you should be able to tell that ammonia is NH4 and its valency is 1 plus. This is what you need to remember. You need to remember that the name or uske relevant, what will be the symbol and what will be the valency. That is why what will be the symbol in the ionic form. So NH4 1 plus is the ionic symbol. Okay, symbol of that ion. Similarly, another important thing what you can see over here is the names given to the negative radicals when they are formed by the same kind of elements. Like for example, if I'm talking about SO3 and SO4. Okay, let's do one thing. We'll take it this way. I'll take first S, then SO3 and SO4. See, SO2 is sulfur dioxide, which is quite stable. It is not a radical. It's a compound. So we are not taking SO2. But SO3 and SO4, both are radicals. And all these SO3, SO4 are basically 2 minus and 2 minus over here. 2 minus, 2 minus and 2 minus over here. Now, how do we name this thing? This is basically sulfur. But when it is going to be in a form of a radical, it will not be the name as... It it will be not named as sulfur. So what will happen? This one, the one which is only the pure element, okay, or one which is only the pure element, uske last elements, uske wahan pe last, that is the suffix to that will be added as IDE. That's why this will become SULPH. UR nikal jayega, banega IDE. Same as chlorine. We knew that chlorine, when it was Cl1 minus, it became chloride. Okay, IDE. Bromine became bromide. Iodine became iodide. Why? Because it was just an element, but in a radical form. It was in the form of a ion. It was not an atom. It was an ion. It has already gained an electron. So it was Cl1 minus. So when it is only an ion, which is only one single sulfur, nothing else, it will be IDE, sulfide. If it is, then you are going to add oxygen to it. If the oxygen is less, the SO3 is less oxygen, it will be ending with sulfite, ITE. ITE is what is added. ITE is for less oxygen. IDE, no oxygen. Or you can say just pure iron. It's pure iron. Whereas ITE, less oxygen. And the next one is sulfate. AT, that is ATE, for more oxygen. If the oxygen which is present in the compound is more, then it will be sulfate or ATE, like sulfate, phosphate, carbonate. Okay, ATE is more. Okay, if it is not having any oxygen, then it will be IDE, nitride, sulfide, phosphide, hydride, oxide. Okay, that will be IDE. If it is less oxygen, then it will be ITE. Okay, sulfide, nitrite, okay, phosphite. So when it is going to be less oxygen, it will be ITE, more oxygen will be ATE, and no oxygen, that is pure element, it will be IDE. Remember this thing. It will be very important for you to understand this, because whenever they are going to ask you that name this or write a symbol for this particular thing, you need to know that wo sulfate hai ke sulfite hai, to SO4 hai ke SO3 hai. Right? Like for example, over here only bicarbonate and bisulfide and bisulfate. So bisulfate, bi means H. Whenever you get in bi something, it means HSO3, HSO4. Bicarbonate will be HCO3, right? So bisulfide will be HSO3. Why? Because sulfide is SO3. Bisulfate will be HSO4. The next is the one which is valency 2. So valency 2 wale, calcium, magnesium. Calcium is Ca, Ca2+, magnesium Mg2+, zinc Zn, Zn2+, barium is Ba, that is Ba2+, nickel is Ni, Ni2+. Same way, in case of a negative radical, the one which are having the two valencies are oxygen, that is O, that is O2-, which will be called as oxide. As I told you, it's only the element, that's why IDE, oxide. Sulfur is S, S2 minus, sulfide. Sulfide, SO3, 2 minus. Sulfate, SO4, 2 minus. Carbonate, CO3, 2 minus. There is nothing like carbonite. So, isliye CO, because CO2 is carbon dioxide and CO is carbon monoxide. So, there is nothing. They both are compounds. That's why you do not have anything which is having less oxygen and it's still in an ion form. That's why SO3, CO3 is the only one which is called as carbonate. Dichromate is Cr2O7, 2 minus. Zincate, ZnO2, 2 minus. and plumbite is PbO2 2-. And then there are some elements which are valency 3. There is aluminum, Al, Al3, chromium, Cr3+, and phosphate is PO4 3-, and nitrogen is N3-, which is nothing but nitride. Okay, because it's only element, that's why nitride, IDE. So elements exhibiting variable valency are copper. Copper has got two valency, copper 1 and copper 2. Copper 1 will be valency plus 1. Copper 2 will be valency 2+. So copper 1 is called as the cuprous, and copper 2 will be called as cupric. Silver will be Ag1+ and Ag2+. Silver 1 and silver 2. Mercury will be Hg1+ and Hg2+, mercury 1 and mercury 2. Iron will be Fe2+ and Fe3+. So that is why iron 2 and iron 3. Iron 2 is ferrous, iron 3 is ferric. Tin is Sn, which is Sn2+ and Sn4+. You can see the variable valency. It's not always that the valency will be 1 and 2. Like iron ke andar 2 and 3 tha. Mercury ke andar 1 and 2 tha. But tin ke andar 2 and 4 hai. So tin 2 and tin 4. And lead has got 4 and 2. So lead 2 and lead 4. So lead 2+ and lead 4+. Phosphorus has got 2 valency. That is valency 3 and 5 because of its structure. And sulfur has also got 2 valency, 4 and 6. That is also due to its structure. So these sulfur and phosphorus are the only two non-metals which has got variable valency. Otherwise, normally the variable valency will be there only in case of metals. Only metals there will be a possibility of variable valency, but sulfur and phosphorus are two exceptions which has got variable valencies over here. So that is about the valency, and we have over here. So what do you define as iron? How do I define iron? So an ion is an atom or a group of atoms carrying a positive or negative charge due to loss or gain of electrons. So sodium ion Na+1 and 1+, and chlorine ion Cl1-. Cation, so I told you this one, cation, positive ions are also called as cations because they are attracted towards the cathode. So positive ions are called cations Na1+. And anions, the negative ions are called as anions, Cl1-. A radical is a group of atoms of elements that behave like a single unit and show valency. Positive radical may ammonium is NH4+, and negative radical may bicarbonate, example HCO3-. So these are about the ions and radicals over here, which are present. So this particular page number 49 is very, 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 very important for you to learn by heart. You should know the valencies of each and every element and radical which are given over here in this table. Each and everything you need to learn properly. You need to know sulfite. So sulfite, you should know it is SO3 and the valency is 2-. If I'm talking about bicarbonate, so it will be HCO3 1+, 1-. So ammonium, then NH4 1+. So you should know the radical chart, that is the valencies and the symbols of that particular compounds or the radicals properly. So a very, very, very important part. You'll know this, why it is important, in the next video.